So you start seeing all the big buildings, the ballparks, the stadiums for Baylor University is here in Waco. That's where the girls' softball plays, right there. Oh, look at that. That's the front of Baylor. Never seen Baylor before. Didn't even know where it was.
No.
I've always heard of Baylor. Wow. Man, that other, you can see just the top of that other stadium over there. It's like a professional football stadium. This for a little bit.
Straight.
Yeah. Texas Sports Hall of Fame is here. Oh, it's right there.
That's a campus.
Yeah. There's the big, huge stadium over there. So, Christina.
So, Douglas.
You found the Dr. Pepper Museum. Good for you.
Good for you.
The old corner drugstore. So it was $10 a piece. Oh, I see how that works. Oh, you are something. It's okay to say that about me, but just not about you for save $2. Hear that, folks? You got me the senior discount, and you're supposed to be 65 years old. She wouldn't get it for herself. Until 1953, this building was heavily damaged, took down a whole wall. This is pretty cool. The old corner drugstore where Dr. Pepper was invented. Who is that masked woman? That is a neat clock.
Dr. Pepper to the Louisiana Purchase Exposition in St. Louis in 1904. Who would have thought that something as simple as that soda would become so popular? I'm very proud of it. And I can tell you that I still check out all the new sodas that come out on the market. Anytime I get my hands on a new one, I take it to the lab and do a couple of tests to see what's in it. Actually, most of them are pretty simple. Well, it's been a pleasure meeting you folks. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to finish up here, buy some more cigars, and get back to work. I'll let you get on with your visit. Thanks for coming, and enjoy yourself.
these little 7 and 8 ounce cans. Half liter in a can. Those little bottles.
Yeah.
In the 50s, huh?
The glass can.
There's the old cans that used to require a opener. Remember those? You used to have a regular can opener. See that, where that one was opened with a can opener?
Yep.
Remember when the bottles used to have this stuff on them? Stuff that they found the bottom of it, I think. I'll have to read up about this. So they had to figure out in this building, they had capped off this well. It hadn't been seen in how long? 30 years? It tells you on this thing. And they jackhammered. And they reopened it so that you could see the well. Wow. Pretty amazing. And then there's a bunch of equipment over here, earlier equipment. A bunch of old bottles in here. Interesting how they have all this old equipment and stuff in here still. Some antique bottling equipment. Vim, vigor, and vitality. I thought the guy was trying to hide away from the camera. He was eyeballing the bottles, make sure there's no dirt or anything.
The electronic eye looks for impurities.
Bottle washer. Chief cook and bottle washer. That little bottle. The little can.
10 to 4.
You don't see a lot of Dr. Pepper coolers, do you? It's gonna be one of the most rare. Oh, it's a vendor. Okay. Mm-hmm. Very cool. Way these are real signs in this kind of condition, they probably are, because they had access to them. Worth a fortune. You see that picture? This is the room where all the research and development took place. Back in the day when this was where they made the Dr. Pepper. Quite the floor in here. It's up and down. Brick wall. Look at those trusses. Pretty neat building. These are pretty cool. Christina said, you're watching TV. All the old commercials. Are they Dr. Pepper commercials?
Yeah.
Oh. Seems like I remember those guys on some other commercials.
2 years and older. Masks should cover both your nose and mouth.
You gotta wear them for 2 years?
Thank you for helping us keep you safe.
You ever heard of piping hot Dr. Pepper? Heated, drinking Dr. Pepper hot. We started out calling it dietetic Dr. Pepper. And that was associated with drinking if you had diabetes. It really killed them. 1962. They had to change the name to diet. It took a while to recuperate from that. Patio. So many different sodas that have been on the market. Diet. Look at that marketing strategy. 7-Up Wet n Wild Lake, just for girls. All right. You only want half the population to buy your product. What a genius move that is. So much cool old soda memorabilia in here. Who remembers this stuff? It had these dots in it. Orbits. Clearly Canadian Beverage Corporation. Instant meal. Hustle. There's one that sounds delicious. Hubba Bubba Soda. That doesn't even sound good. All these caffeine infused energy drinks. So this is Free Enterprise Institute up here. All the companies that this Keurig Dr. Pepper owns. It tells all about this guy, Woodrow Wilson Foots Clements. 60 years he was with Dr. Pepper. He pretty much made it what it is today. Being in sales my whole life, I always like learning about guys like that.
But sure enough, sales increased. Just because I made it a little easier for customers.
This is pretty cool.
My name is Woodrow Wilson Clements.
He started out as a route delivery driver. Worked his way up to the head honcho. And of course you have to empty out into the gift shop. All kinds of stuff. All set, my dear?
Stay with the Dr. Pepper.
Yeah? Yeah, that's kind of cool. So what are you in line for here now, Christina?
I guess Dr. Pepper.
Gonna get your Dr. Pepper sample.
Fashion way, like they used to have a soda jerk. They put the syrup in and then the carbonated. Tastes any different? It's about the same, I guess.
Probably. Here. Moving.
Was it moving? I don't think so. Maybe it does move sometimes. It's a pretty cool exhibit.
Those bottles were moving.
It was moving. It's all 7-Up stuff over here. It's very cool.